Dragons party host Paul Vaughan can no longer doubt the severity of his COVID crime, today sacked from the club. After terminating his contract, St George bosses apologised to fans, members and corporate sponsors for the breach and the fact that players tried to cover it up.
It was a dog of a day for party boy Paul. 3 days after the illegal Dragons drink that upset the state government and his neighbours, the questions remained.
Hey Paul, are you concerned about your career?
If he wasn't, he should have been. By this afternoon, it got much worse. He was sacked by his ashamed club. He spent the afternoon contemplating his future outside his Shell Harbour home. His contract terminated immediately, not just for hosting the victory bash, but also for lying about it.
Paul took the news as you'd expect. He took it quite hard and he was probably quite shocked by the news.
It's poor judgment. It absolutely was premeditated and they knew what they were doing. They understood the protocols and they still decided to do this. So, yeah, it's not an innocent mistake.
It emerged today it was Vaughan's third strike after a biosecurity breach last year when he used a false name to visit a cafe and fresh allegations of a sexting scandal.
Two prior breaches that have also included COVID-related issues.
You mentioned two. Can you elaborate on the other one?
No, I can't, mate.
13 Dragons were at his party, fined more than $300,000 in total and handed match suspensions by the NRL.
They're all very remorseful, obviously.
One of them was Jack DeBellin, who the club supported for nearly 3 years during his rape trial. He told the club he was merely walking his dog past the party. In fact, he was hiding when the police arrived. It's the cover-up which incensed NRL CEO Andrew Abdo.
The fact that the players fled the police clearly indicates they understood what they were doing was wrong. That in itself is disappointing.
The sole consolation for Abdo, that Vaughan's wife was the only non-player at the party. So the NRL's COVID bubble of 900 remains intact, if not the Dragons' reputation. Danny Widler, Nine News.